Hello students, now I am going to discuss the programs I have given for your online assignment 1. Within this programs, few program I have done using recursion and function also. I will try to make you understand. If you will have any problem regarding function and recursion, we will have another session of discussion. But this is the session where I am going to discuss all the programs I have given to in the online assignment 1. So the first program was the program to print the ASCII value of a character. For this purpose, first we have to take an input character from the user, and at the time of printing we will use %d so that the ASCII value of the character can be printed. If we print use %c, then the same character will be printed. If we write ASCII value is %d, in that case corresponding ASCII value of the character C will be printed. Of the character C, here you can see that I have declared a character type variable, that is C, and using this variable I have taken an input, a character input from the user, and the ASCII value of that character has been printed by using %d at the time of printf. So we can see the output of this program using by executing the program. This is the program, and if I execute this, suppose I am giving input capital A. So the corresponding ASCII value is 65 is being printed, right? You can see that here two output screen has been come, and I have to input the character twice. This is totally a problem of the cooperation of in between my laptop and the DevC platform. When you will execute it in your laptop, you will need to input only once, right? I am repeating that in my case, when I am executing the program, I need to execute this twice because two output screen is coming out. This is the because the version of the DevC and my laptop. When you will execute such a version which will go with your laptop or desktop, then you will need to only print only input one time, right? So next I'm coming, I'm showing if we write %c here, then again the character which has been taken from the user will be printed. Only when we are giving this %d, because %d is able to print the integer value, that is why the corresponding ASCII value of the input character is being printed, right? Now I am coming to the next program to check the vowel and constant. For here you can see that in case in lower case variable I have taken ae small a e I o u to and in upper case I have taken these inputs capital a e I o u. So whenever is either any where any input from the lower case or from the upper case happens, then it is vowel, otherwise it is constant. This is a simple program of if else loop. I hope you can understand it very well. I am executing it for you. Suppose E, obviously this is vowel, and if we input some constant character, consonant character, then it will print it is consonant. Next, I am coming to the next program to check whether a number is negative or positive. If the number is lesser than equals to 0.0, then we will check whether the number is same as 0.0. If it is, then we will print that the number is 0. Otherwise, we will print that the number is negative, otherwise positive. So it is a simple program of if else ladder. I am again executing it this for you. Suppose minus 5 that means this is a negative number, right? Now I am coming to the next number, that is printing the GCD, that is greatest common dividend. Suppose I have to compute the GCD of 6 and 9. For that purpose, here you can see that I have taken two numbers from the users and kept in it in N1 and N2, right? So suppose N1 is 6 and N2 is 9. So at the first iteration, when first iteration is being done, then I equals to 1, I less than equals to 6, that means 1 less than equals to 6 and 1 less than equals to 9. If this condition satisfy, then it will check for the next condition, that is N1 divisible by I and N2 divisible by I, and both these conditions, if these both conditions satisfy, then GCD equals to I. So at the after the first iteration, GCD is 1. When next I will be increased by 1, now I is 2, and again these two conditions will be checked. And as these conditions are being satisfied, so these two conditions will be checked. That means N1, that means 6 divisible by 2, this condition is being satisfied. But 9 divisible by 2, this condition is not getting satisfied. So this line will not be executed. And before executing, I will be increased again. Now I is 3 and these conditions will be checked and will be satisfied again. After that, these two conditions will be checked, and for 3, both these conditions will satisfy. Now the value of GCD will be 3, and after the fourth iteration, it will check for 4. You can see this example. At the first iteration, I equals to 1, I less than equals to N1 and I less than equals to N2. n1 modulo 1 equals to 0 and n2 modulo 1 equals to 0. That means GCD 1. After second iteration also GCD is becoming 1. After third iteration GCD is 3. When value of I is 4, then also GCD is 3. When value of 5 is 5, value of I is 5, then GCD is 3. In this way it will start executing. So when the value of I is being getting 7, then these two conditions will not satisfy. That means the program will be exited from this loop, and finally the value of GCD, which is 3, will be printed. That means GCD of 6 and 9 is 3, which is being calculated in this way in this program, right? So let me execute the program for you. GCD of 6 and 9 is 3. Next, I am coming to the next program, that is computing LCM. Suppose we are taking inputs from the users as N1 and N2, and we are taking the same input 6 and 9. So N1 equals to 6 and N2 equals to 9, and this line is putting the value of greater value in between N1 and N2 in mean. In case of 6 and 9, when N1 is 6 and N2 is 9, then mean equals to will be 9, right? In this loop, while 1 means 1 is a universal truth, the truth, because 1 is always there in universe. So this loop is always true. So to get out from this loop, we have to use this break condition. Otherwise, if we don't use this break condition, this loop will act as an infinite loop, right? So within this loop, I am checking these two conditions. Mean, that means 9 modulo 6 equals to 0 and 9 modulo 9 equals to 0. Then I have to print that LCM of N1 and N2, that is 6 and 9, is mean, right? So when mean equals to N1, mean modulo N1 equals to 0, that means it is coming 9 modulo 9. Value of mean is here 9, because this line is computing the greater number in between N1 and N2 and putting it in mean. So in between N1 and N2, when N1 is 6 and N2 is 9, value of mean will be obviously 9. Then within this loop, we are trying to check 9 modulo N1, that means 9 modulo 6 and 9 modulo 9. For that purpose, this condition is not getting satisfied. This condition is obviously getting satisfied, because 9 modulo 9 obviously equals to 0. It is 9 obviously divisible by 9, but 9 is not divisible by 6. That is why these two lines will not be executed and value of mean will be increased by 1. Now the value of mean is 10. Then again 10 9 modulo, sorry, mean is 10 now. So 10 modulo 6 and 10 modulo 2, these two condition will be checked. And again, the both in this iteration, both of these conditions are not getting satisfied. So these two lines will not be executed and mean again will be increased by 1. In this way, when the value of mean will be 18, then 18 modulo n1, that means 6, will be 0, and 18 modulo 9 will also be 0. So when the value of mean is 18, then both of these conditions will get satisfied, and then the value of mean will be printed as the LCM of n1 and n2, right? Let me execute it for you. You can see that the LCM of 6 and 9 is 18. The next program is to print reverse of a sentence using the concept of recursion. In this program, concentrate on this program. Here, the execution will start from main. So first, this line will be executed, that is enter a sentence. After that, reverse sentence, this function will be called. So this function, the definition of this function is written here. So what is done within this function is that within this function, we are getting taking an input character from the user in the variable character type variable C using the scanf function, and then checking whether the C not equals to new line. That means when C equals to new line, then it will stop. Otherwise, it will go on taking characters from the users. So I have explained this program in this way. So when after execution of this line, when reverse sentence function is called, then after using these two lines, suppose I have taken the input as the name. Let me take a short name for you so that I can execute, dry run the program very soon. Suppose I am taking the name Oishi. So the reverse of this sentence or of this string is getting printed. Here I have explained how it is being done. That is, when reverse sentence function is called for the first time, after execution of these two lines, one character A is being inputted from input to the computer. After that, when we are seeing that C not equals to new line, that means A is not equals to new line, then again reverse sentence, this function is again called. After this function is called again, these two lines will be executed and I will be taken as the input, and when I is not supposed to be a new line, then this reverse sentence function is again be called. In this way, A, I, A, S, H, I, all these characters has been taken by the users. When we are getting new line, when we are getting new line, that means when we are pressing the enter function, that means sentence is finished here, then the printf of this reverse sentence function, last called reverse sentence function is printed. Printf all of the last called reverse sentence function is executed. So if we execute that printf, we will get output as I, and next the last but one reverse sentence function is being called, then printf of that function will be executed, corresponding printf of that function will be executed, and we will get h, and in this way we will get the reverse of the entire string, right? I am explaining it for you again. Whenever the execution of the program will start from this line int main, we will execute first, this line will be executed, enter a sentence. When this function will be called, then according to this definition, these two line will be executed. And using these two line, we are taking an input A. So as because A is not equals to new line, then this function will be again called. Then again, these two lines will be executed. So I will be taken, and then S, and then H, and then I. So whenever we are closing the second brackets, the lastly called reverse sentence, when we are putting this second bracket, that means lastly called reverse sentence is getting closed here. So printf, corresponding printf of the lastly called reverse sentence will be executed. And if we execute that printf, we will get I, because the last taken input from the user was I. So printf will print the character I. Then when we are closing this second bracket, that means last but one, that reverse sentence function will be called, and corresponding printf will print the last but one character taken from the user, that is H. In this way, the entire string will be print in reverse. Next, I am coming to the next program, that is getting the largest element in an array. So I am going to take four elements in an array. Number one was 10, then 22, then 4, then 6, suppose. So 22 will be printed as the largest element. So if I want to explain this program, let me explain it for you. So you can see that when this program will be executed, the execution will start from this main function, right? Then the total number of elements which we want to keep in an array will be taken from the users. So if we want to put, we want to keep four integer numbers in an array, then using scanf, we will take four and we'll put in the variable n, right? After that, within this for loop, we are checking when I equals to 0 and I less than n, that means I less than 4, then this line will be executed. That is enter number and scanf. Using this scanf, we will take the number from the users. So using this for loop, we are taking 4 integer numbers from the user. After that, to store, we are going to store the largest number in the position array of 0. That means at the 0th position of an array. For that purpose, what we are doing when n greater equal I equals to 0 and i less than n, then array 0 less than array I. That means when I equals to 0, then array 0 position. So we have taken the input was 10, 20, 4 and 6. This is our array. This was our array. So array 0 less than array I. I means now is array 0 is 10 and array of I is also 10. So if array 0 less than equals to array I, then array 0 equals to array I. So no change is happening. After that, I will be increased by 1. I will be increased by 1 by I plus plus. So after I get increased, so array of 0 that lesser than equals to array of I. Array of 0 is 10 and array of I, that is array of 1, is 22. That means we will put the value of array 1 in array 0 position, right? Value of array I, we are keeping it in array 0 position. We are check, again I will be increased and this check, this checking will be done. And if this do not satisfy, as because array 0 is not lesser than array 2, array 0 is not also lesser than array 3, then finally the array 0 position will be printed. The value kept in array 0 position, that is 0th position of the array, will be printed as the largest element in an array. So I have explained 6 programs, I guess, of your assignment. I am going to explain rest of the 4 programs of your assignment in the next video. So I am ending the meeting here. I am just going to start the next meeting within few minutes.